Hello and welcome to Team VLSI. In physical design, we are discussing about the various files in physical design with analyzing the files in great details. So please do like this video and subscribe our channel. Our channel is www.youtube.com/teamvlsi. So here are the some important files used in VLSI design. For out of these 24 files, we have already discussed about 11 files till open access database. Today we are going to discuss about the VCD file and SAIF file. So let's start. So first is VCD file. Basic information. So VCD file is known as variable change dump or the value change dump. It is an ASCII file and used for power analysis and optimization. It is defined in IEEE standard 1364/2001, support the logging of signal and direction. This file is generally generated by EDA logic simulation tool. VCD file contains basically three sections. First is header section, second is variable section, and third is data section. In data section, change details of each step of simulation has been recorded. So question is how to generate the VCD file. VCD file can be generated during RTL simulation by RTL simulator. For this session, we are going to use VCS tool of synopsis as a RTL simulator. There are two ways to generate the VCD file in VCS tool. First is compiles using the compile switches, and second is using system task commands. Here we will use the compile time switch. So you can use following switch while compiling your RTL to dump your VCD file. So VCS M update RPP, then V, ALU top dot V, then ALU test bench dot V, then output O, switch is O, then test, its output file name, then to run the tool, VCS tool in full 64 bit mode, you have to use the switch full 64. Then debug all. I have already discussed this command in details in my VCS section. There is one session on VCS tool where I have discussed this switches of this. So add-on switch is this one. So R, then dump vars plus dump vars plus test dot VCD. This is your VCD file name. So this switch you have to use in addition, or you can use VCS, then your Verilog file name, and then VI log file, and then this switch. This will also generate your VCD file. Above compile switch will dump the test.vcd file. One important thing, before running the simulation, make sure your test bench has proper termination using $finish, else it could generate a huge size file. So I have experienced in my during my simulation, by mistake I have not terminated my simulation properly. In few minutes running this tool and command, I got a VCD file of 15 GB. That is huge file, because it has recorded a long duration, recorded the dump, recorded and generated the dump of relatively large times. Then I have terminated this program by force. So it had generated about 15 GB of VCD file. So make sure before running this command, you have your test bench have terminated properly. Yeah, so now we will analyze the file. So header section consists basic information of file. So date of the file creation, tool name and version from which it has been created, then at time scale. So you can see here, this is a part of your the VCD file. So here date, then synopsis VCF version and 2017, it is your tool and its version. Then your time scale 1 picosecond. In VCD file, any statement starts with the dollar symbol, yeah, you can see here, and followed by the keyword and the statement with the dollar and keyword, you can see. Every statement is ended with the dollar and keyword. After header section, next is variable section. So variable section here, you can see it is the variable section. So variable section starts with the keyword dollar scope, followed by the module, then module name and dollar and keyword. You can see here scope, then module, and module name here is ALU_TV, and ended with the dollar and keyword. So next is each variable has been defined using the dot. The dollar var and end with the dollar and. Here you can see a format of your variable definition. So start with the dollar var, then variable type. Here is the variable type is var, then its size is 1 bit, then identifier code. This is the identifier code, then reference. In reference it might be your pin, net or pin or wire, then ends with the dollar and statement. Dollar up scope is the keyword to end your scope statement, you can see here. Then end definition statement is used to close the variable definition section. So at the end of definition you have to use the dollar and definition keyword to end your definition section. Next part of this section is dump variable. So dump variables, then here after listing all the variables, this part ends with the dollar end. So you can see here it is the list of all identifier codes which you have used to define the variable, and it end with the dollar end. Next section of this file is data section, where all changing variables value of variables with time has been saved. This section starts with the hash time, followed by the identifier code whose value is changing at that time tick. So you can see here hash 10,000 picosecond or 10 microsecond is starting, and these identifier codes indicates the associated variable with these identifier codes has toggled here. Then next tick comes on at 20 microsecond, and associated identifier code are all these. This file records all the toggles of variable till the end of your simulation. In next part we will discuss about the SAIF file, which is similar to the VCD file. So with this is the end of VCD files. Next move to the SAIF file. So basic information of SAIF. SAIF is a short form of switching activity interchange format. SAIF again is a ASCII format which captures the toggle count of signal in the design. This file is used to analyze the power, again power and power consumption and design, and also used to optimize the power. So as a SAIF file can be generated from the VCD file or directly from the simulation tool, and there is an utility with VFS called VCD to SAIF, which generates SAIF file from the VCD file. So if you have a VCD file, you can generate SAIF file using this command VCD to SAIF, then input. You have to provide the input file name here, input VCD file name here, then output, and output SAIF file name here. So above command will generate test.SAIF file. SAIF file is based on static probability and toggle rate. So static probability that a signal at a specific logic state. So SP1 indicates the probability of signal being at logic 1 state, and similarly SP0 is the probability of signal being at logic state 0. And toggle rate is defined as the number of transitions logic 0 to logic 1 or logic and logic 1 to logic 0 of the design object per unit time. It's called toggle rate. SAIF file is developed by the Synopsys to facilitate the interchange of information between the simulator and Synopsys power tool. Some of the tool cannot read the SAIF file, so there is VCD file used for the power analysis. So here is the screenshot of your SAIF file, a part of SAIF file. So starts with the header part. It contains SAIF version first, then direction, date of generation of file, then the vendors, name of EDA vendors, here is Synopsys, then program name, it's VCD to SAIF here, then time scale, here is 1 picosecond. This file starts with the keyword open bracket SAIF file and the open braces close at the end of this file. Okay, so one thing as defined here is duration. So duration is defined as the total time of simulation for which toggle activity has been captured in this file. So here it is 710000 picosecond, that is 710 microsecond. Now file analysis. Next part of SAIF file starts with the instance section. So you can see here instance ALU_TB. It contains instance name and it's all the nets name. You can see here. Each net contains T0, T1, TX, TC and IG duration. You can see T0, T1, TX, TC and IG. These symbols has specific meaning, as T0 indicates duration for which the net remains in logic state 1. Similarly, T1 is the indication of duration for which net remains in the logic state 1, and TX is the duration for which the net remains in the logic state unknown state, and TC is the sum of rise and fall time. Similarly, IG is the sum of glitch time from either logic 0 or from logic state 1. After ending the statement of states of all the nets of one instance, next instance section starts, and the states of all the nets is written as the previous section. You can see here, after ending of the one instance section, next instance starts, and similarly its state has been recorded here. Same procedure has been repeated for all the instances. Then SAIF file presents system dynamic change rate and usually used to dynamic power analysis. So you can see here, this is the T0 means the time for which A1 remains at 0 states, and total time for which the A1 remains, net A1 remains at logic state 1, and its transition time is unknown state is 0 and its transition time is 63 picosecond and there is no glitch. Okay, so with this we have ended the VCD and SAIF file. Thank you for watching. We'll meet in the next session with some more files description. So please do like the video and subscribe our channel. Our channel is youtube.com/teamvlsi. Thank you for watching.